हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। माई सेल्फ राकेश कुमार शर्मा, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग, आर्य कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड आईटी। सब्जेक्ट इज MEMS एंड नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी। इन लेक्चर 9 वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक स्कैनिंग टनलिंग माइक्रोस्कोप मींस STM। The basics of STM is this is the device used for imaging surface at the atomic level, and this is invented by Gridbening and Heinrich Rohrer in 1981, and it is not only used in vacuum but also in air, water and various liquids. The scanning tunneling microscope is an electronic microscope that transmits three-dimensional image of the electron cloud around the nucleus. It is very important technique in determining the atomic structures and the electronic states of the surface under the investigation. Surfaces can be viewed in the electronic size to the high resolution than that of STM has. And the principle of STM is this is based on the concept of tunneling of electrons. Wires applied between the device and surface allows electrons to tunnel even in vacuum, and the current produced would depend on voltage and position of device with respect to sample. Tunneling current in a metal, the energy levels of the electrons are filled up to a particular energy. This is known as Fermi level. And in order of an electron to leave the metal, it needs a additional amount of energy, that is phi, that is also called work function. The electrons need a overcome a barrier phi to travel from tip of specimen and vice versa. When a shaped metallic tip is brought very close to the surface of the conductor, an electric current can be detected due to the tunneling of electrons through the air gap. In this case, this air gap is considered as the barrier. When an electrical voltage V is applied between the gap and sample, this tunneling phenomenon results in a net electric current, which is known as tunneling current, and the tunneling effect, the basic TSM is a quantum tunneling theory. According to the quantum tunneling theory, when the energy of an electron exceeds its total energy, it can penetrate regions which are impossible according to the classical physics. And so it can tunnel. And we can say, in other words, if the two conductors are brought closely to the each other by approximate 10 angstroms or more, then a potential difference is created between them, एंड द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर लाइकली टू टनल थ्रू द पोटेंशियल बैरियर बिटवीन दीज टू सरफेस दीज टू कंडक्टर्स एंड द वर्किंग ऑफ STM, there are two modes. First one is constant height mode and second one is constant current mode. In height mode, the voltage and height are both held constant while the current changes to keep the voltage from charging. This leads to an image made of current changes over the surface. The benefit of constant height mode is that it is faster as the piezoelectric movements required more time to register the height change in constant current mode. It is also the applicable only when the sample surface is rear flat. Generally less preferred due to the risk of damaging the tip. And the second mode is constant current mode. Feedback electronics adjust the height via voltage to the piezoelectric height control mechanism. In this, the height variations and the image comes from the tip topography across the sample and gives a constant charge density surface, which means contrast of the image is due to the variations in charge density. It is the time consuming method compared to the constant height mode. As the feedback control has to adjust the current constant according to the height, as the tip moves along the specimen or sample surface, and the working of STM, the main components of STM are variation insulation system, distance control and scanning unit, control voltage for piezoelectric scanner, and the data processing and display. Now, the working of STM, the probability of defining such tunneling electrons decreases exponentially as the distance from the surface increases. The STM makes use of this extreme sensitivity to distance. The sharp tip of tungsten needle is positioned a few angstrom from a sample surface. A small voltage is applied to between the probe tip and the surface, which is causing electrons to tunnel across the gap. As the probe is scanned over the surface, it registers variations in the tunneling current, and this information can be proceed to provide the topographical image of the surface. In metals or conductor, electrons appears to be freely moving particles, but this is illusory. In reality, the electrons move from the atom to atom by tunneling through the potential barrier between the atomic sites. And these are the most component of STMs, which are scanning tip, piezoelectric scanners, distance control and scanning unit, data processing unit, and vibration isolation surface. The tip and surface distance must be maintained in angstrom, which is equal to 0.1 nanometer, to get a desired atomic resolution. And the advantage of STM are, STM are versatile. They can be used in ultra high vacuum, air, water and other liquids and gases, and also it gives the three dimensional profile of a surface, which allows researchers to examine a magnitude multitude of characteristics, including roughness, surface defects and molecular size. The lateral resolution of 0.1 nanometer and 0.01 nanometer of resolution in depth can be achieved. And the disadvantage of STM are, it is very expensive and also need specific training to operate the system, and it is need to very clean surface, excellent vibration control while operating. Single atom tip. Thank you, students.